the oil spill, we'll call it that, that we're working toward in the Gulf of Mexico is vacating enormous millions and millions of barrels of oil every week. The flow of oil coming out of the ground is much, much larger and not controllable. They cannot stop it, and they will not be able to stop it for at least another year. That oil will eventually make its way up the East Coast, across the Atlantic, and coat the beaches in Europe. When the hurricanes start popping and it picks up 10,000 gallons of petrol, benzene, oil, and dumps it on the cities and dumps it into the soil, into the food supply, into the water supplies. It dumps it on the people, on the animals, on the vegetation. You won't be able to survive that. Now, keep in mind, we have another approximately 7,000 oil platforms pumping oil out of the Gulf of Mexico. It's the end of the fall line coming down the Mississippi right there. So you're going to see more and more earthquakes, maybe in Mexico down at the other end of that. You'll see earthquakes accelerate. If that oil ever depletes and you have a giant cavern underneath and the frigid ice water goes into that hot earth, you could have a major catastrophe. That could very well cause the splitting of the line all the way up to the Great Lakes. 600 feet high water from all of the Great Lakes emptying into the Mississippi and finally winding up in the Gulf of Mexico. Millions of people will die. St. Louis, all the major cities along the Mississippi will vanish. All of the buildings, all of the food crops in the lands that produce food, Arkansas, all the states will be at least cut in half. Tennessee would be cut in half. Missouri would be cut in half, all the way down. It would be a disaster of the first order. God only knows what's going to happen. There's no precedent for that. There's nothing in history anywhere in the world that will equal what will happen once that occurs. The question is, what are you going to do with 40 million people, and how are you going to feed them? And it's chilling to think of the answer. There is no way to feed 40 million people. There is no way to house those people. But yet plans are obviously in place to relocate them. If you view it as taking care of the people, if you do it like that, you would say put them in the FEMA camps, but don't lock the door. But now, if you're a fascist government, that's a different light entirely. It's another piece of the puzzle. It makes the situation a little bit clearer to me from all I've been able to gather. It does not surprise me.